Hello, I'm Christina from Milan Creative Co, and in this tutorial I'm going to show you how to convert RGB or CMYK colors into Pantone colors. If you are not familiar with it, Pantone is a standardized color matching system. The Pantone Solid Color Palette was originally made to help designers and printers specify and control color for print. That means if you send a Pantone color to your printer, you will know exactly how that color will look once it's printed. I'm used to working primarily for web, and I often create color palettes in RGB or CMYK color modes. Fortunately for me, Illustrator has a quick and easy way to convert color palettes to Pantone colors. I have here a seamless pattern I made, and this is the color palette I used for the pattern. These are 5 rectangles that I filled with each of the colors I used for the design. We are going to use the Swatches panel, so if you can't see it, just go to Window, and scroll down until you find Swatches. I'm going to move this up here so you can see it better. We are going to add these colors to the Swatches panel. So either select your Swatches if you have them on your screen, or just select your artwork and then go to the bottom of the Swatches panel and click on this folder icon. Make sure selected artwork is checked, and also check include Swatches for tints. You can also rename it if you want and then click OK. And as you can see, a new color group will appear. If you select the color group, you'll notice that a new icon will appear. This icon won't appear if you just select a single swatch. So let's select the color group and click on the icon. This will open the Recolor artwork tool. We want to recolor our artwork, but we will use this tool to convert our swatches into Pantone colors. Make sure your color group is selected, and then go to this little swatches icon. Click on it, then go to color books. And you have here a few Pantone color books. I'm going to choose Pantone Solid Coated because this is the most popular Pantone color book. You'll notice that the new color palette will have this little white triangle at the base. This is the icon for spot colors. And if your artwork is selected, the new colors will appear in the artwork. If you want to save this color palette, click on the folder icon. If you want to rename the color group, just double click on the name and let's call it Pantone Colors. Then press OK to save it. You'll notice that the new color book will now appear in the Swatches panel. So let's move this over here. And I'm going to make a copy of these swatches so I can show you how they look side by side. As you can see, the colors are pretty similar, but there's a problem because the white is now gray. This happens because white is not a color in the Pantone color book, but if you change the colors, white or very light colors might turn to gray, so I am going to replace this with white. White in the Pantone color book is actually transparent. If you have a Pantone color guide and want to create a color palette using Pantone colors, you can go to the Swatches Libraries menu, go to color books, and then choose the Pantone guide you want. I'm going to choose solid coated again. Now you can select colors from here, or you can enter the name. Let's search for Rubin Red. As you can see, we have 2 colors over here. And to add it to the color palette, just double click on it. I hope you've enjoyed this tutorial. If you want to see more Photoshop or Illustrator tutorials, please subscribe to my channel or visit my blog. Thanks for watching!